for nearly almost, I thought he would have covered in 1 hour, but he has already taken around 1 hour 45 minutes. So fine, no problem. I think if you all got the right intent, then I mean, right content, what you were expecting, that would have been great. Hope you all have got a basic understanding of what is cloud and how you can easily develop the applications on cloud, right?
It's disturbing people. I'm concentrating more here.
From the initial thing, we saw that most of them are into freshers and not used to cloud platform development, right? So I've seen a couple of startups here. People have raised. So how many of you are from a Java background? Okay. How many of you are from Node.JS background? Python. So actually, we will so how many are familiar with developing the simple web applications? So what is the runtime you use?
I'm not sure if he's audible till the end.
Mine is fine?
Yeah, yours was pretty good. I'm trying to see if we can order something from Swiggy.
Okay. O'clock, what is the session happening here? What is the another session happening here?
I'm not sure if it's a 3, I think it's around 4. I'm not sure what the session is about.
Kapil was just chatting with me, like, you need a single form, you want to collect all your guys' data.
You want to create the form.
Like name, email,
Google,
and mobile
Google form.
So what
just
it
create
takes,
a Google form.
How much time does it take for
forms
you to develop
Google.
Com,
I think, is the address.
Okay.
You just need 3 inputs.
Name,
email, ID, phone number.
No, I'm trying from a, coming from a very layman terms, okay? I don't want to try to jump to the code and so Kapil had a simple application. He said that, okay, Yukesh, you were talking so much about your IBM Bluemix stuff like that, right? Can you build us a simple web application with collecting the name, email and mobile number. Simple page, and I want to collect all your guys' data. So how much time does it take for you guys to do this?
So I guess he is going to develop that only. Yeah. So
and how will you give this app to others to enter? You might develop it on your stuff, okay, on your laptop. Do you have a domain and hosting? Do you have it?
You need a domain.
So how much time does it take? So I just want answers from you guys. So we'll keep it interactive, okay? Okay, let us say, before all these things, right? You need a setup. How many of your laptops have all this runtime database, all these tools available? You don't have it, right? Now, first you have to go, I have to install runtime. Okay, Node.JS runtime. You go Google and search and download. Okay, right?
How familiar are you with this locality? Not much.
I think I have seen one bakery. Not bakery, I don't know what is it. I really don't know.
Assuming your setup, everything fits in properly.
We have Karachi bakery somewhere around 1 kilometer.
Yeah, that I know.
Or your database is something, it's having some dependency problem here. Some error is coming in your machine, okay? So it might take another hour for debugging you all that stuff, okay? Okay, so 1 hour. Right? Now next is fine. Now you've got all the things there, right? You've installed all the things. Now you have to connect all these guys. You have to connect your server, you have to connect your database, you have to connect your runtime. I mean you have to have a connectivity, right? So how much time does it take? I'm audible there, right? Please do ask questions, okay? So probably all this connectivity. And other thing is, sometimes guys are more interested in finding out any frameworks available for all these things, right? You might be finding a Java Eclipse framework. Node, do you have any like WebStorm, I guess, not sure if you have it. So that is a different part, but all the connectivity would take right? So your setup, you are actually downloading all these guys, you are actually make sure that nothing is breaking across whatever versions you have downloaded. Yeah, that is important. Again, let us say you have downloaded a database may be compatible with some specific versions only. Okay, you have to make sure that all the versions you downloaded and all the components you downloaded are in sync with all the versions, right? So you have confirmed with all those things, you might have taken another hour and you make sure that all the connectivity is there. Now we're all set to go. 3 hours is something, all the setup, okay. The development based upon your, let us say another hour you might take for development, right? So this is good. So assuming that 4 hours you have developed it. 4 hours it took for you to develop a single page web application thing. Now this is good and running on a local machine, on a local laptop, right? Now you have to, I can't ask all the people to come to your name, please. Amir. To Amir's laptop and please type your email, password and mobile number, right? It doesn't make sense, right? So you want to host it somewhere. So assuming you have the hosting in some GoDaddy or some hosting thing, you already have it. Assuming it will take another 30 minutes. You push it and everything is up and running. I'll have to do the runner. Don't figure it, right? You don't know all the apps. Run it. So if you're already has it, 5 hours. Fine. This is good. Now Kapil will come and say, hey, I also want to add a company name also. He'll come and say, no, I don't want name, email, mobile number, I want the company name as well. Whether he's a student or he's a working guy or how many experience. So you want to add some two another edit boxes into the same thing. So how much time does it take for you? one more hour for changes. One more hour, right? Okay, this is good. Now, Kapil will say that, okay, this is really good. He wanted some other, another page, another page wherein you want to have your complete details from your 10th class marks, intermediate, degree, or whatever it is, B.Tech. Another, see, he is a customer, right? He will ask in satisfaction. Initially, tell I want this only, but slowly he'll come and ask. Whenever you go to buy something in a shop, right? First ask, then he'll ask, hey, this one will be. Slowly you come to that bargaining thing. So even Kapil has that, he has that ability. So he'll come and say that he wants another page with all the details, like 10 standard, what are the other things. Now, you see that your project is growing up. Initially it was a single page, now your project is growing. Now you say you might be tied up to some other thing. So you want another A. You might ask your friend, ex-friend, Mustafa. So last Amir will ask me, Mustafa, there is another page yeah. So to add kar de, aur wahan pe, so how are you, how Mustafa will have your latest code? How Mustafa will have it? Does Mustafa has the latest code with him? Well, what Amir has? No, right? Pardon? Probably you can, so zip te de, main answer karke main karta hu. Everybody understands Hindi, right? I'll try to answer and I will do the code changes. So let us say he might first have to understand the code. Iske paas environment hai ki nahi? Arey yaar mere paas environment. So this guy again. So Amir has taken all this pain to set up his laptop, right? Now Mustafa is coming here. And again he does the same stuff. Right? But Kapil says, I want it by evening. I don't want to wait for next day. Yeah? I want it evening today, not two evening, right? He wants it. So but now Amir is tied up with some other work. He busy with some other works. Now we are giving it to Mustafa. So Mustafa will have to set up all this stuff and he will take another 7 to 8 hours. Because he has to understand the code. What this guy has written, and he will make sure that it is working on his environment and fine. Now we will go and try to push on domain. Some issue comes there. Push the dependency missing here. Amir has done all the work. He knows what it is there. He has pushed it properly. Now Mustafa is trying hard to push that onto Node. He might call Amir and say that why it's not getting pushed up. So all these things come in and it might offer back and forth and all that. It might take another 2 hours for actually. So you might give up that day and start next day fresh. Again, to resolve the dependency, Amir has to come pick up the latest code from Mustafa and again he will take a zip of it. He will go and see what are the changes this guy has done and then he will upload the final stuff. So you see, right, even for a small change, we are taking around like, all these guys are repeating. Or let us see, a project has gone very big. Very big. Another 3-4 developers comes in. So how are we going to track all these things? Data, good. Right? You need a source control for that. Okay. Once you have the source control, at least your code is being shared by your multiple guys. Okay. But the infrastructure is never shared. Still you are working on your local machine, you are working on your local machine things, right? If people are understanding, right? If any questions, please do stop me and ask. Okay, now where are we? Okay, now you are saying your source control is there. Everybody understands source control, right? GitHub, you have clear case, you have SQL, and there are multiple source control. Yeah. So you can use any of those things. So GitHub will host the repository in GitHub and it'll say to all his developer friends or some community saying that, okay, you guys can contribute to this one. So that you will be able to track the changes in the project and they will be able to merge. All the guys can see the project at a shot. Once it develops this thing, you need not do any sweeping of the things and giving it to all the guys, okay? So that is where source control management comes in. Now for source control, again, what you have to do? You have to install Git, right? Now everybody has to install Git. Okay, now we are installed on your local machine, fine. Now infrastructure is not same. The laptop may be for one configuration and that guy's laptop will be in a different configuration. N number of people, N number of configurations. Right? Fine. Now, you people have developed to all these things and probably will come up with some more requirements and you people have developed. But you see that the final delivery of pushing your app to all the guys, right? It's always taking around, like, let us say after GitHub it might take around like 2 hours. Right? You got right? Because there will be one leader, let us say Amir is the owner of this project, okay? He is the owner of the project. So multiple people will ask for a merge and then he has to merge it accordingly, right? You cannot really merge the changes after this. So it takes another 4 hours for you guys to actually push the right thing. Now let us say Amir's app has become a very hit. I mean it's like super duper. People are flocking this app. I mean flocking the elect. 1,000, 2,000 requests. Now one your domain and your hosting will not support that. So what do you say? Load. Right? The load is not supported. Now you have to go for a new load. So how much time does it take? So again the GoDaddy will say, I cannot support this much here. You go to some controllers or something or some Amazon. You AWS or some Azure, Microsoft, you go there and you buy your infrastructure and you. So now again all this stuff you have to do there. You buy a VM, you buy a virtual machine, okay? You buy a virtual machine and you have to install all this runtimes. Right? And then you will import it. So it will take another some more time. Now, tomorrow Kapil will say, hey, the mobile number, you have given, we are accepting even the text. Mobile number may text as signature. It's only a simple numeric thing, right? So you please change that numeric to numeric. So how much time does it take for you to do the small things? Minutes and you have to verify, right? You are not breaking other things, right? So you have to do some testing. You can't directly go and upload it, right? So you might have changed some numeric, but you might be writing some validation somewhere with some text string, which string equal to this much length. You might have done, right? You might have missed a step, right? So you might have missed the validation altogether. You have to use the app. You have not done the testing. So how much time the testing will happen for this small change? Now that testing guy will wait and he will do again. He has to verify all the things. Okay, you will think that okay, bar two karma you testing, I'll write one script. You go and say I'll write one script, okay. I'll write one automated script. Whenever a new change comes in, I'll have to run through all these tests. Right? But how much time does it take to write those scripts again? So from all this is what I am trying to come over here is, so even for a small change, and the thing is nowadays, this is the traditional way of developing a simple application, okay? This is the traditional way. Now, your name is?
Akshay.
So Akshay, okay, Akshay was some, you are in the college or the college. He might have got a very good idea, okay? Why don't I create one simple page for my college? Just events, whatever, simple events. And then you wanted to host it and make sure that, okay, Akshay has developed this app. Okay, developed this web application. You wanted to host it somewhere. So, yeah, at the very first time, he's enthusiastic, it's got a good idea. Okay, now he comes running and runs in. Dependency, it's okay. Forget it. his skill, his idea there itself. He's not even gone forward there. Right? You got right, guys, what I'm trying to come to that point where how IBM Bluemix helps you with all the secret. Okay? I'm trying to tell the pain points in the current traditional way how we are doing it. Okay? So you have to give your idea. Like that, there might be many ideas you guys have, but you don't really go there. And let us say this domain and hosting part, let us say you have developed an app, okay? You might develop a local app. And I had a domain and hosting, again, it's a cost, I'll not even do. If you want to show it to someone, he has to go there and first initially buy the domain and he has to do all that stuff, right? So in his, he might have put his brakes on his idea at this point as well, right? So this is how the traditional web application development happens, okay? So you have to manage your infrastructure, you have to manage your hosting, and the delivery of your software also is also important, okay? Once your web application grows, right, you need your web application changes to be up and running within no time. Earlier it used to take like 2 releases in 1 year. One version comes in, another version comes after 6-7 months. But now people, in mobile application if you see, in 15 days you will see a new update in a mobile app. New version coming in. So how fast they are able to give it that way. That is how the trend is going on now. The world is changing. It's fast paced. So any small changes have to be up and running within no time. So in order to do all this stuff, right? In order to do all this stuff, it takes a long time for you guys. So let us say if someone comes and tells you, "Arey yaar, ye sab to ek button se ho jayega." So how happy or how interesting you will be? In one step of a button, okay, all my runtime is configured, all my database is configured. I do not worry about all of it. I'm only worried about my code. Kya karna hai? Okay, this string is there. I need to go and change the string. Okay, you forgot the test case of equals to. But you might have a build passing stage as well. There is some validation steps will be there. You see that the devotion of your time will not be devoting any time over here. Your only devotion of your time would be developing your application and logic of your application. That's it. You're not worried about your runtime, your database, your dependencies, you're not worried about it. And you're even not worried about your hosting as well. Right? Well, that way you can concentrate on other development of your applications. Right? You're utilizing the right over there, okay, for application. So this is the traditional web application, and that is what IBM Bluemix actually now, as Dictates has already provided you one runtime explaining about Java and how it is. So in addition to that, you will see how we connect a database and we'll try to design the same form. Okay? Are you all with me, right? Any questions?
About this, I know.
2 days. I'm just logging into my Bluemix account. I'm just logging into my Bluemix account. If you want to just follow me, you can always follow me.
Okay.
So this is my login, I'm in Bluemix account. So I'm not just explaining anything about the Bluemix UI, as already Yuktesh has already gone through. And in addition to what he said, right, our catalog is there, right? The catalog has a very good documentation of each and every service. It's very, very good. I mean, I can bet you today, none of the cloud providers have the best documentation. I mean, IBM has it. It's so easy to just go through that the catalog and you can develop apps in a, like, on your fingers, actually. So what I'm going to now is I'll just go to the catalog, okay? So you already know about this Cloud Foundry apps, right? Madam, someone asked for a Microsoft thing. So you already have a ASP.NET runtime. Okay, you already have it. So there are like 9-10 runtimes available for you guys. I'm only aware with only Java and SDK. With my interest, I just learned through all these things. Okay. So Swift is also there. So you guys are aware of Swift?
iOS.
Exactly. So right now we'll go ahead and create a simple Node.JS runtime app, okay? So what name shall we give? I'll give Kapil project, Kapil's project, and this naming it May 20. Don't worry about the pricing stuff and everything. Just go ahead and create. You all guys are in 30 days trial period, so no, don't worry about that.
Sure, app name must be unique.
So don't give the same name, okay? you give a different name, okay? Okay, while that's getting started, right? You could see once you have created the app, it's gone into getting started one. The first and foremost thing is you need to download the sample code. Okay, this is the sample code. Guys, okay? Just say yes or no, because I just want to know that you people are understanding. Okay. I just clicked on it. It's downloaded for me. Okay? You guys can see it over here, right? Right? And the other part which Yukesh was saying is like, okay. Right? Once you download the sample code, it's on YouTube. code. You never got any environment or anything. Okay, you only got the code. Can do that in any text editor or anything. Now once you do the modifications here, you can set that from Eclipse, we add the CF Cloud Foundry plugin to actually push those changes over there. Okay? So there was a plugin called Cloud Foundry. You have the plugin here. So here you could see the Cloud Foundry CLI. So this is on.
Please
download that one, okay?
Sir, it's a control
menu. Yes, download.
Download. Download the sample code, and in order to push your changes to the Bluemix side, you have to use the Cloud Foundry CLI. So please download that CLI as well onto your system. Okay? So any push onto this one, you have to use the CF command line. Okay? So your bridge between your laptop and your IBM Bluemix Cloud platform is the Cloud Foundry. So using Cloud Foundry only you will be able to access the apps on your Bluemix thing and download the things. Okay?
Install that CF, it's a lightweight software. Install and go to command prompt and just be there.
So you could see this is the zip file, okay? I'm just copying it into one of my workspace. Okay, now I'm unzipping it. So I unzipped the zip file which I downloaded. You could see that there is a basic sample project available for you now. Okay. Actually, I'm using the Sublime editor. I'm not sure if you already have that. Kapil project May 20. So this is my project. Have you people downloaded this? Okay. So there are a couple of things. Now you need not really go into the Bluemix platform and see for other stuff. Okay. You can actually do your coding and directly push the code and you can see the latest changes available. Okay. So the files for interest on this is, so there is a manifest file here, okay? There is a YML file. You could see the project name over here, Kapil project May 20, right? And the memory used is 256 MB. So all these things, if you go to the UI, right? If you go to the UI, you could see all these guys here. The 256, and 1024 instance, right? Okay, fine. So this is the actual starter file, the app.js file, okay? And you have an index.html file here. So by default here you could see that if I go ahead and click on this one, Kapil project, this is the thing we have it, okay, hello world. So now I've downloaded the project on my machine,
Now I'm simply changing the hello world to the same stuff what we earlier did for Java project one, okay? We will go to the next level as well, but I just wanted to show you the CF capability, command line capability. Welcome to CloudMine by IBM Bluemix. CloudMine IBM Bluemix session. Right? This is the one. Now, even before I want to push the changes, right? I want to test it locally, right? Even before you want to push it onto the main server, you want to test it locally. So I just go to the command prompt, okay? So right now, please do ask questions. Please do ask questions if you have any questions. Okay, now I already have my node installed in my machine, okay? I see that it started on localhost 6006. So this is the, you could see the URL, this is the, the people domain URL which you need to share across your team members or whatever it is. And this is something localhost, 6006. Welcome to CloudMine. So this is on my local machine. I have not yet pushed the changes onto the main one, okay? Now this seems good for us, okay? Okay, my changes are available. I am able to see it. What I'll do is, I'll go ahead and I'll do a push. So how do you push now? How do you connect? How do you know that you are pushing into your space, right? Your ID. So I'll just say CF, you could see that CF, once you download the Cloud Foundry CLI, you should be able to see something like this, okay? I'll do a CF login, okay? And I'm hitting enter. It asks for my email name. Email is something which I logged into the Bluemix, right? And it asks for the password. It's authenticated. Okay. Now it's asking for an organization. So which org you have selected? It's VCHI. So say 2. You just select 2. Now it's targeted to that organization. Since I have only a single space, it directly took the default space for me. If I have multiple spaces, it will ask for which space you want to push this app for. Okay. Now it's connected. I showed you this YML file here, right? So, if I do a push of it, right? You could just please observe the screen, okay? Once I click enter here, it is using the manifest file. So it knows that it has to push the app onto the Kapil project, whatever it is, the domain. It uses that. So it says updating the app. Kapil project V20 in organization this. Okay. Sir, you asked for the build one, right? It does the build over here. You could see that. Now it stopped the app. Okay. Now it's starting the app. This is the build. So it's creating a container, right? It's creating a VM backend with all the dependencies, node dependencies and stuff like that. Pardon? No, this is not local instance. I'm pushing the app now. So it's creating it on the Bluemix, on the fly. So it installed the binaries required. It installed IBM SDK Node.JS. You're seeing it, right? All you guys will have the same environment.
So we talked about quick prototype. It is still the same, right? Except
not
you need to have the continuous delivery provider. I will say, show you that how you can apply the continuous delivery to this. So let us say if your staging has failed, you should not go to production. You can do the things. I just wanted to make you familiarize with the basic application. Then we'll go to the DevOps thing. Okay. Now you can see that your app has been deployed and it's been started. Okay.
Sorry, this is having a problem.
Now your app is running. Okay. Now I go to the this one. Okay, this is the actual URL you had, right, for your app. Now I just do a refresh. Okay, your app is deployed now. Now, what was our requirement? Okay, we wanted to create a simple page, right? Form. So you are now got familiarized with how you want to push the app from the local machine, right? That's a Windows machine, right? You do a set path, no? Okay, now this is how your app has been installed and stuff, okay? Now what I have to do is I need to go here and I want to add, I need to create a form, right? Create a form. So what all things I need to know about creating a form? So this is something, nothing related to IBM Bluemix or something. It's a simple development thing, HTML. So I already have that snippet available for me. I'll just copy that. Okay.
లోకల్గా ఎక్స్క్లూడ్ చేసినా కదా లోకల్ హోస్ట్ 6006 అని అది అందరికి వచ్చేస్తుందా లోకల్
లేదు అందరికి రాదు నీదండి సిఆర్ లోకల్ టెస్టింగ్
మరి నా లోకల్ మిషన్ కదా వస్తుంది నేను అది లోకల్ అది ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ చేయాలంటే
సో can you all guys see over here, I'm just adding a simple div here with the name and the email, okay, and immediately checking if okay, I'll just remove this guy, I don't want this, and I've added a simple button, okay, on click, and I'm just printing the whatever values I have. So I just save this file. So even before I go ahead and push it onto the Bluemix, I just do a local testing of myself. So you could see that I have a name, okay. Okay. I say name as my name as Virender, and my email ID is okay. And I'm doing a save. There is some uncaught reference. Okay, I need to add the Angular JS file.
Okay, now you see that error has gone, that Angular JS file, I need to include that. This is the name. Right now I have not added any validation. It's a plain two edit boxes. You could see that I got the details saying that save the record with these details, right? Now this is fine. This is fine for us. But I need to save these details into database, right? Think that is struggling with something. Okay. Probably after this one round, right, you people can try it yourself. It's a simple app. So now we need a database, okay? So for this, we just go to the Bluemix this thing, okay? Now I go to the catalog, right? So right now, the database is supported on IBM Bluemix only NoSQL database. There is no relational database support. So you are aware, right? It's a document-based database. JSON database. Okay. So you people can select this particular service, and you can do a create of this service. Okay. Because I'm not doing that step because I already have a CloudEnt SQL database available, a service, okay. So I'm just going here. Are you people trying out the stuff? I mean, you can create a service, I mean, parallelly, probably. Okay. So once you click on this service, there is a launch button here. Once you click the launch, you guys are familiar with databases, right? MySQL Server, you'll have multiple databases, multiple instances. In similar fashion, once you click on this launch, right, you could see a database tab. So right now I have two databases, demo DevOps database, and there is a Node.js database. So right now demo DevOps, there is no records available. So we'll use this particular database to actually store the details of the name and email, whatever you're entering there, right? So how do you connect your app to this database now? So how you guys connect to a database? So where we can find this particular service database credentials now? We have to figure it out, okay? So once you clicked on that service, you click the launch button here, right? From manage, you could see the service credentials here, okay? Just click on the service credentials. I guess you'd not see any credential available. You could just click a new credential. Just click on new credential and it'll create you a credential, okay? Once you have created that, just click on this view credentials. Okay, these are the things. You have a username, you have a password, you have a host, you have a port, you have a URL. If you are using a client, okay, from a Java application, if you are using a CloudEnt client jar application, you need username, password, for connecting to this particular database and the port number. You could see a URL also here. URL is something that this cloud end database is providing a REST-based API calls. Right? You need not download a jar as well from a Java application. All you guys are familiar with writing a web service, right? A REST call. So you can directly use this particular URL and do the basic CRUD operations like create, read, update, and delete stuff. So what I'm trying to do here is I'll just use the URL path directly. Okay. And in a cloud end database, you can create one service and you can create multiple databases for different projects. Only the database name changes. So this is my project. Okay. Now, how do I save this? I need to have a connection and I have to save this. Now my web application should be able to do that call, okay. So I am actually doing, I'm using a HTTP code here. So I have collected the information in this data, okay. This is AngularJS, okay. I'm not sure if people are familiar. So this data, now we saw that a name and email was there in a record in a JSON object, okay. And I'm doing a post of this on a path. This is the path. So this path is nothing but your REST API. So you have to write that, your application, you have to write that REST API call, okay. And you're passing in the data. So this data I'm passing into this particular API call, okay, right. So where is this API call to be written? This API call will actually have the code to connect to the database and it will do a create of that particular record, okay. So where we write this particular code is in the app.js, okay. So this is where we write. So as I said, like already have this part of code. Here you could see that I am using application JSON header as application JSON. I mean, if you are already familiar with developing REST calls, right, there is a content type. You are telling the content is text or application JSON or a file or a image or something, binary file. So that is what the content is all about. It's a protocol. I mean, I'm not doing anything new here. Okay, it's a basic protocol for developing REST calls, okay. And the database name is my demo DevOps, right? The URL which we saw in the credentials there, right, I just copy pasted over here, the complete URL, that is a cloud end host for me, okay. Now if you want to connect to this particular demo DevOps database, I need to just append the cloud end host with my database name, okay. So if you could see the URI I'm forming here, cloud end host plus database, right, got it. And I'm using a method post. And I'm saying the data which I'm sending it is in the form of a JSON object, okay. And I'm just calling, I'm just executing that particular request, okay. So even before you're seeing that I'm using the request package. So for that in a Node.js, you need to do a request, you need to add the library. It's a require is nothing but a library in Node.js, okay. And the other one we need to add is the body parser. Okay. okay, now I have created a post call, okay, post call with this part, demo DevOps V1 store data, okay. And if you could look at the HTML here, I am saying demo DevOps V1 store data. I am passing the data from here. So the data which you passed here will actually go here and come here, and it will be actually within the request. Request body will have the data, whatever JSON data you have, okay. Remember that I have not yet pushed my app onto the main Bluemix app, okay. I am just testing locally. Now let's see the how it works, okay. I started the server, right. This is my local host. I'm just giving my name. Now I'm doing a save. So this is the details. If you go and look here, the response code was 200 and it successfully created the document. Let's go to the database now. I'll just do a refresh. You could see a document got created. Just open that. My name and email. So this ID and revision is something which Cloud and DB creates internally. So we are not worried much about that. Our content was name and email. Now this is something which I am running from a local host, but the database which I am connecting is something which is already residing in Bluemix. Database is not on my local machine. You guys, you see, are seeing the difference right here, right? They are using the database on the cloud. And there you would have actually installed the Cloud End in your local machine and you would have tested it there. But I am directly using the database there, right? Now I see that this my code is running well and fine. Now what I'll do is, now what shall we do? I do a CF push. So once it is done right, so what we have seen here, we have created a simple Node.js runtime and we have connected a simple database. We have created a simple form and a button, and now I am storing the details into the database. Sir, you have any questions? Okay, the other thing which I want to say is, now since we while this is happening, right, I'll tell you other thing. Now this is basic thing which we are using in a Node.js application. Node has multiple packages, right? Node has multiple packages. Let us say I've added a request here, right? I might add other libraries, right? If you add other libraries, how would your Bluemix container there knows about those libraries? You might be adding multiple libraries and using in your project, but it will not be able to pick up which libraries it to install. So for that, there is a package.json. You all guys see, look into this one, okay? The engine which is used by all of us by default is the Node.js version of SDK 4 version. Okay, so again you have to go to the request where you have installed and you have to see. So if you want to pick up the latest one always, right, you can say x.x.x, right? So it will pick up whatever the latest you have, it will pick up. So now let's see, hopefully it should work. Now I am doing a CF push. So you got to know, right, how you to debug the, what is the error, build error. This is a build error. So even if I forget to have a syntax error here, and if I try to do a push, it will fail. You can always do that all in the same process. Have you all got familiar how easy it is to develop a simple web application? Right? No questions, right? Let's hope this gets passed. this bit get passed. You could see now it's installing request. It's installing a request package 2.8.8.1. I mean, it's picking up whatever is the latest one directly picks up. Or you want to have a specific version, you can always mention the version there. Not sure if it's picking up any other error still, and any build errors are there. It's again failed. Let's go and debug why it failed now. You could see here again, right? It says that cannot find the module body parser. I'm just trying to, even I'm trying out the very first time, okay? I'm just trying out as you people are doing it, okay? So we have added another package as well called require body parser. Okay, I need to add that as well. So I go here, I add the body parser. Now I'll say pick up the latest whatever it is. Now first what we'll do is we'll see what all requires we did now. We don't want to again fail it, okay? So we added the express package, we have added the CF package, we have added the request package. Now we added the body parser package. Four packages dependencies we added. Okay, now if you look at this, all the four are here. Right? Now let's give us a try again. Hopefully it should work now. I'm also hoping it to work. So always remember that you are getting errors, you should not get distressed, okay? The more the errors, the more you learn. If your app is running the very first time, right, then you have failed it in future. You should know the things, okay? Why it is failing then? Now if we could have not encountered that error, right, we might have missed those things, okay? The more the errors, it's always good. Now you could see that build is successful and the body parser is there. Now you see that the app is started. Okay. Now you guys can try that Kapil, what is the project name? Kapil project May 20. Now let's go here. Okay, this is my project, right? I do a refresh. All you guys, now please enter your name, email or whatever. Instead of email, right? Just put a comma and enter your mobile number as well. Guys, okay, I don't have energy to again add a box there. Can you all guys please do that? Please. Please enter your name, your email, comma, your mobile number. We will see if all the all your guys' information is available in the database. And probably you can try out a guest call on this, okay? To see how many records are available in the UI. Are you guys doing? Let's see. I'll just go here and I'm seeing the records. Oh, I see there are around 15 documents already available. Okay. Amir Khan. Okay, this is good. Super. So, guys, details are there. Tushara. Good. So I got around 20 documents now. Thirty-four documents.
So you see how easy is it for you guys to develop a simple web page application with this, and how happy you are feeling now, right? So this is what Bluemix offers. Okay, there is only the basic stuff which I try to explain to you guys, the simple basic life cycle in any company, any project, a simple web application, database, and we can add a lot of monitors and other stuff like SMTP, video and messages. There are many services available in Bluemix. You guys can explore it and you can assign it. Let us say a record has added. Now, how do you want a message to come to your mobile? This guy has been added. So you have one service called Twilio. So you can add that Twilio service there, and you have some username credentials. Whenever a new record is inserted successfully, you say send a message to my mobile. You can do those things. Right? A lot of innovative things with very simple manner. Any questions till now? No, right? So we'll see how easily you can add a source control to this project, okay? So this is my app. Okay, even before I'll just talk in while I just do that. So you have this overview, right? You guys see this overview? You could see a continuous delivery tab here. Right now it says that continuous delivery is not enabled for this app. Okay, now what I'm going to do here is I'm enabling this continuous delivery, okay? So what does this do? Once you enable this continuous delivery, it adds a source control repository to your complete project, so that you can share this source code across your developers, okay? And then it will also allow you to create tasks like sprint planning. You guys are aware of agile this thing, right? Sprint. So you can create tasks. So how do you know that for developer one you have to give this task, developer two you have to give this task? So all those things you can do it in tracking, issue tracking.
So we'll see how it comes up. So it's asking me to create this. I'll just go ahead and create it. So you could see that there are three tabs here created: think, code, and deliver. So this is the continuous delivery pipeline to your project now. So this is the issues. The issues is nothing but you can create a sprint, you can create multiple tasks and assign it to developers. So okay, now the other question is how you will add these developers into access particular project is through Git repository. Okay, so you could see that there is a Git bin configured for your project, and there is a delivery pipeline here. Sir, this was the question you asked, right? If I click on delivery pipeline, there is a build stage and there is a deploy stage. The build stage was something when we do a CF push, right? It was actually building it. So you could see that we failed twice. We forgot to add a request of a body parser and something, right? When a build fails, right, it will never deploy into the production. If your build passes, then only it deploys it. So all those configurations can be done over here, okay? Run jobs when previous stage is completed. So if your previous stage is build stage, it failed, it will never deploy this. So like that, you can add multiple jobs. There are around like 15 to 20 available. So let us say once your build is deployed, right, you want to let your testing team or other quality team to know, intimate them, right? Or you want to send an email, the build is ready, it's in the production. So you can add those Slack, you can add those email services as well. So once your build is completed, you can give a QA at mail.com. So all the mail goes to all the QA developers, a group, sort of thing. Exactly. So this is about the final deploy one. Now let's go and see the Git one, okay? So this is the source code control, okay? Guys, this is the, I'm not sure if you people are already aware of how the Git looks. So this is how your Git looks, okay? Your repo. Now you want to share this repo link so that other developers can work, right? So where is the repo link for this? This one. So this is the Git URL. But you could see this SSH sort of thing. Since this is a private repository, only you can see it. So once you make this as a public, anybody can see it, right? But in an organization, I mean, I don't want to club that part over here. I just want to leave it as is still here. Probably you can explore a little bit more until here, and then we can, the next coming session, we can see how you can, an organization can create a project and assign that particular project to set of developers. I mean, not all developers will be working on all projects, right? Only a set of projects. So those things can be configured. That is a completely source control management stuff, okay? Now the other thing which got added was issues. If you click on these issues, right? This is track and plan. I'll do a simple small change here and I'll show you how it works, okay? I'm creating a new issue. Please change the title. Okay. Title should say May 20 workshop as well. Okay. You are creating a task. Okay, you are creating a task now. Assign it to whom? Right now, I am the only person. I am assigning it to myself. Okay. And I am selecting the due date. Okay. It should be completed by today itself. And I am submitting the issue. So like that, in an organization, you will be having some 4 to 5 developers. You can assign it to those persons. So once that person logs into this particular Bluemix, right? Once, if I go here, if I click on issues, right? Since I am the logged in person, I see, okay, there is an issue created against my name. issue is nothing but a task. It can be a task, okay? Okay, I just go ahead and see here. Okay, please change the title. Okay, now how do I do this? I have a new branch. Anytime, whenever you are trying to develop, right, you always create a branch. I don't know if you are already familiar with source code control. You create a branch. I'll create a new branch. Okay. I created a new branch now. Now where do I change that file, okay? In index.html. I am editing direct edit here. So this is the hello world. What was the name? May 20 workshop, whatever it is. Okay. I did this. See the target branch here. The target branch is something which is a new branch. You're not actually targeting to the master branch. Okay. Now I'm doing the commit changes. Now changes have been committed. Okay. Then I'll create a merge request. So you should ask admin to merge these changes. I do a create merge request. Right? And I'm assigning it to, since I am the only person, I'll get assigned. Submit merge request. Source branch is it, target branch is the master. Okay. Now, if I log in, right, I will look at the merge request. Okay. Some X person is asking for merging this changes into the master branch. Okay. I just go and click this. Okay. Okay, now you don't blindly go and merge the changes, right? You want to know what changes this guy did. You could see the changes tab here. Oh, okay, this guy has changed from hello world to some text change has been done. Okay, this looks good. You do an accept merge. Once I click this accept merge, what happens is whatever these code changes are going into the master branch. You could see that merged. So my request has been merged, okay. Guys, now you need to see the delivery pipeline, okay. Now I have not done any CF push here. I did only a merge of it to the master branch. But you could see that the stage is passed and now it is being deployed. The build is passed automatically. See, I did a merge into the master branch. It immediately is pushing now to the, it actually ran in the stage. Now the stage has passed. That means the build is fine. You can push it onto the main production build. Now it is, you see the stage is running, it's deploying. It's automatically. I'll show you the configuration of this one, build stage. See here. Run jobs whenever a change is pushed to the Git. I mean, whenever your branch master is being changed, someone has merged the change, it automatically triggers this build. And if this build is passed, it will deploy it back immediately. So you could see the branches here. There was another new branch which has been created by me. So only any check-ins have been done to the master branch, that time only your actual app will get deployed.
Push also will work.
So where that code update will go?
Where that?
That code update, whatever they do, let's say you want to change your code, you need to skip out the
Git. Yes.
Now where that code will go?
Now you have to actually come from the Git one. The Git code, you have to, okay.
Git,
you have to work on the Git one. Your Git is the latest one now. Whatever we did locally has gone now. That was the reason I was seeing if someone would have pointed that in the index.html I was having a hello world. But rather you could see that earlier my application I have changed it to IBM Bluemix workshop. All that code has gone. Okay. So whatever your Git is there, right? You just go here and see. Your app.js is not having your body parser request and all that stuff I added, okay? It's gone. You got the point, right? So now what you have to do, my local push will not work now. Anything what I have to do, I have to fetch the code from the Git. So you guys know, right? So now how do I fetch this code here? So you do a Git clone and do all that stuff, and that all again is based upon the source control management development. So you do the merges and anything. Any merges there by to the master will automatically push it to the app. Got right? Got the point. So you saw, right, how easy it is for us to create a simple web app project and ask multiple developers to develop, and once they do a merge, automatically my code is deployed. A simple page, we did it in almost like 1 hour. If I would have sit myself and done it, I would have done it in 10-15 minutes. Any questions? Was it useful? Anyways, thanks guys for your time. And any questions, please do.
Now let us say the build has happened, right? How you want to send an SMS? You wanted to, you guys know Slack, there is a Slack channel. So you want to tell that, okay, build has been done, it has been deployed, the new product has been deployed. You want to notify into some channel. So you can add those things there. Right now, there is only a default one, is the build stage is done, deploying. After deploy, you want to add a new job. So to connect, to notify the Slack channel. So you can do those things as well.
So this is what actually I wanted to cover. So this is nothing but DevOps. Actually, I had a slide to tell, but I felt like coming through an example would really make you understand rather than telling the theory. So I just didn't want to go there. So you saw, right, how easy for you it was to develop. Can anyone tell me, are you guys know about any other cloud providers? So what is the difference between IBM, Bluemix and other providers?
See, the only thing that I say is mostly it's that you are giving the for the providers, you will have choice to use the external one, you will provide the most, like I will say, it's more consistent now.
So the only, IBM Bluemix with Microsoft Azure or AWS.
So even some of the time, like you have got to operate those stuff, right? It's
this is in Bluemix.
I think a cloud library is a
ship to IBM Bluemix cloud.
So it says
See, now you have configured, you have created a runtime app and you added a data, product database. Do you think that is on a single case? You do not worry about those things.
Okay.
You do not worry about those things, right?
You mean the application?
Everything will be done. Everything will be done. That's what I'm saying. And the availability and stuff like that, right? Let us say, let us say now your app is grown. I mean, your load is increased, right? You can increase the instances something over here.
That would be there.
And your database, is also on a different layer. So multiple. You need not worry about those things. What, right? So it's automatically saying that it's a two-tier environment, right? You need not worry about those things.